So for programming, you need to understand a concept called language process. Language process. One minute. So already we know the machines or computers, it will understand ones and zeros. The machines understands ones and zeros. We know that simple task we can manually do, but complicated task, in order to do the complicated task, we need computers. We also know that computers will not work automatically. We have to instruct the computer. But computer will understand only in ones and zeros. So we cannot write a code directly in terms of ones and zeros. That is very, very, very difficult and it is impossible. It's very, very difficult and it is impossible. There is a technical name for this. This is called object code. Machine code, object code. Whatever you want, you can call this. So people started thinking about programming languages. It can be a high level language or low level language. So programming languages. These are programming languages. They are called source code. This is object code, source code. So programming languages has come. Say for example, you have Python or C. You know how to write a code. I want to compute. I want to compute simple interest. So I know how to write code. But this particular, but my computer, it will understand only in terms of ones and zeros. So in between the source code and the required object code, you have language process. You have language process. This language processor, it can be a compiler, it can be a assembler, or it can be a interpreter. It can be a compiler, it can be a assembler, or it can be a interpreter. We will discuss one by one. So as I said earlier, types of language processor, there are three things: compiler, assembler, and interpreter. First one we'll discuss compiler. The high level programming languages like C, C++, C Ash, Java, they use the concept of compiler. They use the concept of compiler. So you just see, you have source code, you have object code. Object code is nothing but machine language. This is high level languages like C, C++, Java, something like that. In between you have the compiler. So what is the difference? So all these three, they convert programming languages into object code, which is ones and zeros. What is the difference between compiler, assembler, and interpreter? So compiler, you just see, in a compiler, the source code is translated to object code successfully if it is free of errors. If there is error, until there is error, your source code cannot be converted to object code. So how it will work means, you are writing a C code. You are writing a C code. What you will do? First, you will go for compilation. You will compile. After compilation, if there is no error, Okay, if there is no error, it will allow you to go for execution. Okay, so what happens after compilation? You can go for execution. Okay, after execution, what will happen? You will get the object code so that you will get the machine understands and it will give the required output. But what happens if there is some error? This compiler will give the error. Fourth line, there is a mistake. Sixth line, eighth line. Like that, it will say what compiler will do. It will read the entire program and it will display all the errors. So you need to rectify all the errors. Once you rectify all the errors, then again you have to recompile. Okay. So you have to recompile. You have to remove the error. You have to recompile. Okay. So assembler. What I'm doing, assembler, I will talk at the end. Let me go for interpreter, because compiler versus interpreter. Because in Python we are using interpreter concept. Okay, I want to tell interpreter first, then we will go for compiler. So interpreter, what happens? Each and every line of the source code, okay, that is translated to the machine code. Okay, so it is executed immediately before moving to the next line. So say I have 10 lines of code, I have 10 lines of Python code. So first line, it reads first line. Okay, if it is having no error, directly it is translated to, okay, the machine language. Then the next line, it is translated. Say there is a error at the seventh line, it will display the error. So we have to rectify the error. Again, it will read eighth line, ninth line. So earlier, the entire program is compiled, it displays the error. Here it is not like that. So up to, say for example, here there is a error, up to the sixth line, okay, that is converted to the machine level language. Okay, this is the basic difference between compiler and interpreter. Okay, if there is a error in the statement, the interpreter terminates. Okay, it's translating process and displays the error message. Okay, the interpreter moves on the next line for execution only after the removal of the error. These are the examples. Python, MATLAB, they use interpreter concept. Okay, so we are going, whatever we are using in Spider IDE, that is basically an interpreter. This is very important, whatever we are using. So if you write your code, you can easily understand this concept. If you write a 10 line code, if it is having no error, then no issue. If it is having error, then it will pinpoint that particular line. So don't think that only there is a mistake in the seventh line. If you correct that mistake, again it may show some error at eighth line. Okay, after correcting that eighth line, again it may show some error at the 10th line, whereas in compiler all the errors are displayed together. Okay, then assembler. Okay, basically this assembly level language is called low level language. Okay, one example of this assembly level language is say microprocessor 8085 microprocessor, 8086 microprocessor, they use assembly level language. These are low level languages. It is used to do only some specific tasks. So you use assembler to convert the source code of low level language to object code. Okay, something like if you remember, I think you might have not studied, in some course you will study, say they use something like move a, b, they use the concepts of registers, okay, arithmetic logic unit, all those things. So assembly language is a low level language, so assembler is used to convert that low level language into one sense use. But we are not going to discuss about this assembler much in this course. I want to compare compiler and interpreter. Okay, this is very important. A compiler is a, is it clear now? Okay, a compiler is a program which converts the entire source code into executable machine code. Okay, So the entire program is considered. Whereas here, interpreter, it considers line by line. So every line it will check, every line it will translate to the machine code. Okay. So compiler takes large amount of time to analyze the entire source code. If there are many mistakes, okay, so you have to correct everything. So obviously it will take more time. Whereas here, okay, only it looks like it is taking very less time, but actually speaking, if you see the whole thing, overall execution time, compiler is actually fast. Okay, so you know what are the errors, so everything you can correct together. Whereas here, it will at a time one error it will say 7th line, then 26th line, you have to correct. Again, you have to execute. Again, it will say some error. Again, it will say some error in these lines. So even though interpreter, it looks like interpreter is taking less amount of time, but actually speaking, compiler is fast. So compiler generates the error message only after scanning the whole program. This is the point I have highlighted. So debugging is comparatively hard as error can be present anywhere in the program. So here it's not that much complicated. Debugging is easier. Okay, and this is it generates intermediate object code. Okay, because you have the program, then it compiles, it gives some statements. Okay, so it generates some intermediate object code. So here it's not required. Directly your program is translated line by line. It is translated to the machine code. Here the examples are C, C++, Java. So Python, MATLAB, they are the examples. They use interpreter. Okay, so softwares. What are the types of software? Then we discussed operating system. Then what are the language processes available? So again, we are narrowing down. We are going to discuss only, we are going to use only the interpreter. Okay. Then so now we are ready. So we have to write a program. Okay. Now we are ready. We have to write a